Hey guys, I'm Angelo, and welcome back to Crypto Coin Consultants. There's been a long-standing issue behind scalability in the cryptocurrency world, with many different ideas on how to solve it. Zilliqa is one such idea. Today, I'll be telling you 10 important facts about Zilliqa and what they're doing in the world of cryptocurrencies. But first, answer this quiz question. What is the origin of the name Zilliqa? It's a play on the word silica, it's derived from the word zillion, it was based on the element zinc, or it was inspired by someone's surname. Let us know what you think the right answer is in the comment section below, and stay tuned to find out the right answer. Before we continue, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the like button to stay tuned for more crypto-related info. Number 10. What is Zilliqa? Zilliqa is a next-generation blockchain platform designed to scale in an open, secure, permissionless distributed network. Zilliqa is the first platform to implement sharding on a public blockchain, a core feature that enables a platform to tackle the same scalability issues that major blockchains are currently facing. Zilliqa uses transaction sharding, which basically means that the network is divided into smaller component networks that are able to process transactions in parallel. As a result, the mining network will expand in accordance to the increase in transaction rate. Number 9. What is scalability? Scalability essentially refers to an increase in the throughput of blockchain technology. Or simply put, it's an improvement on the number of transactions per second, TPS, that a blockchain can process. As of this recording, Ethereum can support around 7 to 15 transactions per second, and Bitcoin's numbers are even lower, at 3 to 7 transactions per second. As a result, these networks can become bloated and have to increase their transaction fees. In other cases, they can be slowed down or brought to a halt, unable to keep up with the number of transactions. Such was a recent case for Ethereum with the growing popularity of CryptoKitties, one of the world's first blockchain games. It exposed Ethereum's limitations as it significantly slowed down the network with just a few thousand people playing the game. In order for the blockchain to truly emerge as a disruptive force it's been poised to be, it must first become faster. This becomes particularly obvious when we compare it to traditional centralized systems like Visa, which can sustain a daily throughput speed of 2,500 to 5,000 transactions per second. Visa can crank up their speed even higher if necessary, like during periods of extra demand, such as during the holidays, for example. Nevertheless, the team behind Zilliqa believes they've found a way to rival these numbers and offer a much-needed solution to the blockchain scalability issue. Number 8. What is Zilliqa's solution? Zilliqa's technical white paper provides more than enough information on its intricate processes, which I'll briefly discuss with you here without making it too tech-heavy. The team behind Zilliqa concluded that in order to achieve a truly scalable solution, a clean slate design and a new type of blockchain had to be built. As I've mentioned before, sharding lies at the heart of its operation. The team behind Zilliqa discovered a way of increasing the number of processed transactions with the number of nodes that join the network, thus achieving linear scalability. For security reasons, they've placed the minimum number of nodes that join the network at 600, and in order to avoid bottlenecks, there will also be a max limit. Each group of 600 nodes is referred to as a shard. If, for example, the network was to operate with 1,800 nodes, it would divide itself into three shards. Each of these shards is tasked with processing a fraction of the network's transactions. As the shards work in parallel, their assigned transactions are processed into microblocks. The DS epoch represents the end of this parallel processing period, and the moment when microblocks are assembled into a full block, which becomes part of the blockchain. Nodes are assigned shards randomly, but we'll also know if they're part of the same shard. Every component operates in a trustless manner. It's also worth mentioning here that with a network of 10,000 nodes, Zilliqa boasts that they'll be able to rival the daily throughput of Visa or MasterCard. In its private testnet, Zilliqa reached 2,488 transactions per second with 3,600 nodes in the network. Number 7. What is a DS committee? Several nodes will be chosen to manage the various shards for each DS epoch in a democratic and decentralized way. These randomly selected managing nodes are known as the Directory Service Committee, or DS Committee for short. They're tasked with directing the network and deciding which nodes are assigned to which shard. The DS committee assigns new transaction requests to a shard for processing and will ultimately assemble the microblocks that the shards created into a full block. The DS committee then runs consensus on the new block before it becomes part of the blockchain. Number 7. What is Zilliqa's consensus mechanism? Essentially, consensus in Zilliqa occurs in two layers. It first takes place at the shard layer, where consensus is reached on microblocks, and then at the DS layer, where it's achieved on the final blocks. Zilliqa employs a hybrid consensus mechanism. It uses proof of work at the start of each epoch to establish mining identities and to perform network sharding. Establishing identities through proof of work protects from Sybil attacks, which is when one bad actor overwhelms a network by creating multiple identities. Unlike other blockchains, Zilliqa doesn't use proof of work to achieve consensus. Proof of work isn't performed by every miner on every block, but instead at larger intervals. Rather than proof of work, the platform employs an optimized practical Byzantine fault-tolerant protocol for consensus. Quick side note for those who don't know what the Byzantine fault-tolerant tolerance is, check out my video on proof of work versus proof of stake by clicking on the card at the top right corner of your screen. If you're not familiar with practical Byzantine fault tolerance, or BPFT, here's a simplified explanation. It's a high-throughput consensus mechanism that has finality, meaning the last step in the protocol requires network nodes to sign that they've all seen and agreed on the proposed block. The block is added to the chain if and only if all honest nodes have signed off on it. BPFT ensures security by operating under the assumption that a portion of the network's nodes are hostile. In the project's white paper, the team has identified several advantages of the BPFT consensus protocol. BPFT can leverage a small consensus group for efficiency, and it's less energy consuming than proof of work, as it's not as computationally intensive. BPFT gives finality to its transactions, thus guaranteeing no temporary fork will occur due to the consensus protocol that doesn't require the same confirmations that proof of work does. Zilliqa is not alone in its implementation of BPFT, as Hyperledger, Tendermint, and Neo also use versions of this mechanism as well. Number 5. How will dApps and smart contracts run on Zilliqa's sharded blockchain? While transaction sharding is a fairly straightforward process requiring little communication between shards, the same cannot be said when it comes to running decentralized apps or smart contracts on a sharded blockchain. The actions of smart contracts must often depend on checking other variables, states, or functions. This means that the shards would have to communicate a lot, which in turn would require processing power or bandwidth, and this can end up neutralizing the advantages of sharding. At the moment, an efficient and secure state sharding scheme has yet to be found. When contracts are allowed to run separately in various sharded states, there are a number of potential issues. These include excessive cross-shard communication, challenges to reconciliation, or the risks of contracts becoming more vulnerable to potential attacks. As of this recording, Ethereum is working on developing a potential solution to state sharding. But in light of these issues, smart contracts on Zilliqa will only focus on data flow and functional programming, not yet allowing for checking, changing, or storing states. The team behind Zilliqa has stated their future intent to research state sharding and how to securely implement it. Current applications enabled by Zilliqa include highly scalable computations like advertising supply chain, shared economy, automated auctions, or financial modeling. Number 4. What is Scilla? Scilla is a new programming language developed by the Zilliqa team, the syntax of which is similar to Solidity, but with one major difference. Scilla works through a separation of state and function, meaning it distinguishes between the communication aspect of a contract and the computational work it performs. Here's where the major difference kicks in. The new language is not Turing complete and thus is less flexible and more limited in nature. It won't support applications requiring conditional statements or infinite looping. Nevertheless, it also comes with advantages, particularly in the form of security, since the fact that it isn't Turing complete means that it can be subject to formal logic proofs. Number 3. How is Zilliqa more advantageous for miners? As I stated earlier, Zilliqa doesn't use proof of work to reach consensus, but rather as a means of preventing Sybil attacks and establishing identities. Since energy usage associated with processing transactions in Zilliqa will be lower, the cost of processing transactions on the miner side will also be reduced. Because of the fact that during an epoch, miners can reach consensus on multiple blocks, they'll be guaranteed more stable rewards with low variance. Competition among miners in terms of transaction fees will also be less intense, due to the high number of transactions processed every second. Even though transactions are carried out at lower fees, this doesn't imply insufficient incentives for miners. The high throughput in Zilliqa means that the aggregated sum of incentives from several transactions will compensate for the low fee per transaction. Number 2. ZIL. ZIL is currently an ERC20 token based on the Ethereum blockchain that may be exchanged for Zilliqa-native tokens once the mainnet is launched. The team raised around $12 million in Ether through private funding near the end of 2017, with the plan of raising more funds via a public sale. Because the price of Ether spiked, however, the funds they raised in the private sale turned into $20 million, which coincidentally was the project's hard cap, thus negating the need for a public sale. But high community interest in Zilliqa led to the team allocating 4,448 Ether worth to a public sale. Number 1. Who is behind Zilliqa? Zilliqa has a strong team behind it, largely consisting of computer science academics and highly respected PhDs from some of the world's top universities. The project was conceived out of a well-funded initiative from the University of Singapore. Xinshu Dong, a cybersecurity expert with several national security projects in Singapore to his name, will act as Zilliqa's CEO. Prateek Saxena, a research professor in computer science at the National University of Singapore, is the project's chief scientific advisor. His research influenced the design of app stores, web standards, and browser platforms that are still being used today. Some have argued that since the team and its advisors are mostly comprised of people with hardcore tech and science backgrounds, there's a tendency to let the technology speak for itself, rather than to generate marketing hype. This may be somewhat regarded as a weak point, since hype is what drives a lot of the interest in the crypto world. However, considering the innovations that Zilliqa has brought forward, as well as the ones it has planned for the future, its technical voice might prove to be loud enough after all. So what is the origin of the name Zilliqa? If you guessed a play on the word silica, you're right. The platform's name was actually inspired by silica and silicon. Just as the computing industry is powered by silicon, the team behind Zilliqa hopes that their project will be used to power the next generation of high-throughput applications. Note that price touched, and at times, came close to touching the trend line more than 3 times. Late October, early November saw price test it and break through, but it was suddenly pulled back down until it broke through again in mid-November and reacted violently,